Principal sir, Ship in charge sir, teachers and all my dear friends. Today I am going to explain about tantrum. Today I am going to explain tantrum through activity video. Let's start our session. Before starting my tantrum activity video, we should know what is a tantrum. Let's know what is a tantrum. Tantrum means seven boards of skills is a dissection puzzle consisting of seven flat polygons called tans, which can be arranged to form various other shapes like number, alphabets and pictures. The objective of the puzzle is to form a specific shape using all seven pieces which cannot overlap. There are over 6,500 different shapes created using the tangram puzzle. When the tangram invented and how it became popular? Invention of tangram. Tangram have been invented in China around the late 18th century and then carried over to America and Europe by trading ships. After a short time, it became very popular in Europe. During World War, it is one of the most widely recognized dissection puzzle in the world. It has been used for various purposes like amusement, art, education. Let us see how to make tangram through the video. Let us see how to make tangram. The paper should be square paper.
Now we are going to fold a long diagonal. So take this corner, make sure fold it from this to that corner. So let us mark out the diagonals with the help of pencil and ruler. Now let us fold along a second diagonal and join the corner and fold it over here and press little bit and open it. Take the scale and draw line from one corner to another. Now fold and draw a line. Now take this corner to here and press and draw line with scale. Now we have to take this edge between these two, fold, draw a straight line with the help of pencil and scale. Mark the polygons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Cut out each of the pieces. two big triangles, one small triangle, rhombus, one medium triangle, square, and a small triangle.
In the similar way, we trim all the color chart papers.
Let's see how to make a rocket. Let's see how to make tangram of Running Man. Let's see how to make a duck. Here are few tangram shapes. Tangram of rocket shape, tangram of running man, and tangram of duck.
See how interesting a tangram is. You can make kinds of shapes like animals, birds, numbers, and alphabets. Hope this video is useful to make tangram puzzles. Thank you.
Good afternoon, respected teachers and my dear friends. Today I am here to teach you a topic of maths. But before moving to my main topic, I would like to show you a few things. Can you guess what shape it is? Yes, you got it. It's a cuboid. It has length, breadth, and height. And it has six rectangular planes. First, second, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth. Examples of cuboid are duster, pencil box, books, etc. It is a shape of a cube. It has length, breadth, and height, and it also has six faces: face 1, face 2, face 3, face 4, face 5, and face 6. Examples of cube are dice and eyes. The difference lies in the fact that the cuboid is made up of six rectangular faces and the cube is made up of six square faces of same size. These faces encloses an area within, which is called the surface area of cube or cuboid. Now, here comes today's topic, which is surface area of cube and cuboid. Surface area of a cuboid equals to its area of six rectangular faces, which is known as the total surface area of the cuboid. So, the total surface area of cuboid is twice length into breadth plus breadth into height plus height into length. One important point to be noted is that the length, breadth, and height should be expressed in the same unit, that is either in meter or centimeter square. Surface area of a cube equals to the sum of all six square faces, that is, so surface area of cube is equals to 6a square. Total surface area comprises of all the areas constituted by the six faces together of a cuboid or a cube. But if we exclude the bottom and the top and find the sum of area of four faces, then we get the lateral surface area of cube or cuboid. The formula for finding lateral surface area of cuboid is twice length plus breadth into height, and the lateral surface area of cube is 4a square. Let us solve some examples relating to this topic. Now, moving on to first question. A cubical box has each edge 10 cm and another cuboidal box is 12.5 cm long, 10 cm wide and 8 cm high. First, which box has the smaller total surface area and by how much? And the second question is, which box has the greater lateral surface area and by how much? In the question, it's given that h equals to 10 cm, length equals to 12.5 cm, breadth equals to 10 cm and height equals to 8 cm. Now, what we have to find is total surface area of cube and cuboid and lateral surface area of cube and cuboid. Now, we have taken the cubical box total surface area as S1 and cuboidal box total surface area as S2. So, first we have to find the cubical box total surface area. So, the total surface area of cube is 6a square, we all know. Then, here the edge is also given 10 cm. So, by putting the values in the formula, we get 6 into 10 square, we get 600 cm square. So, this is our answer. So, the cubical box total surface area is 600 cm square. So now we have to find the total surface area of cuboidal box, which we have taken as S2, and the length is 12.5 cm, breadth is 10 cm and height is 8 cm. So we all know that TSA of cuboid is twice length into breadth plus breadth into height plus height into length. So S2 is equals to 2. By putting all the formulas, we get 2 twice 12.5 into 10 plus 10 into 8 plus 8 into 12.5 cm square. So, now twice by multiplying 12.5 into 10 we get 125 plus 10 into 8 is 80 and 8 into 12.5 is 100. So, by adding all this and by multiplying 2 we get 610 cm square. So, the total surface area of this cuboidal box is 610 cm square. In the question, it is asked that which is the smaller and by how much. So, we will just subtract S2 minus S1, which is cuboidal box minus cubical box. So, we have got the values 610 of cuboidal box and cubical box we got 600 cm square. So, by subtracting it, we got 10 cm square. So, the cubical box is smaller than the cuboidal box by 10 cm square. So, this is the formula to find TSA. Now, we are moving on to LA. So, we have taken cubical box as L1 and cuboidal box as L2. So, we know the formula of LSA of cube. That is 4a square. So now we will solve this equation and we are getting 400 cm square. So this is our lateral surface area of cube, that is we get 400 cm square. Now we have to find the LSA of cuboid. We all know that LSA of cuboid is 2 twice length plus breadth into height. So all the values are given. We have to put it in the formula and we have to solve the value. So by multiplying 2 into 22.5 into 8 cm square, we get 360 cm square. So the lateral surface area of cuboid is 360 cm square. In the question, it is asked that whose lateral surface is greater and by how much. So we must subtract L1 minus L2. So the L1 is cubical box and L2 is the cuboidal box. So by subtracting cubical box from cuboidal box, we get 40 centimeter square. So by this we know that the cubical box is greater than the cuboidal box by 40 centimeter square. So this is our answer. Volume is defined as the measure of space occupied by any object. Volume of cuboid is length into breadth into height and volume of cube is a cube. It is given that length is equals to 4 cm, breadth is equals to 2.5 cm and height is equals to 1.5 cm. So we have to find volume of 12 matchbox. For that we have to find the volume of 1 matchbox. Then we know that volume of matchbox is in the form of cuboid. So we know that volume of cuboid is length into breadth into height. So we have put the values in the formula, 4 into 2.5 into 1.5 centimeter cube. So we get 15 centimeter cube. So volume of packet containing 12 matchbox equal to volume of 12 matchbox. Then we will multiply 12 into 15. So that we can get the volume of 12 matchbox. So by multiplying 12 into 15, we get 180 centimeter cube. So our answer is 180 centimeter cube. So volume of packet containing 12 matchbox is 180 centimeter cube. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I am going to explain arithmetic progression, also known as AP, chapter number 5. Now what is an AP? It is a list of numbers in which each term is obtained by adding a fixed number to the preceding term except the first term. Now let us clear it with an example. First example, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. In this example we can see that each term is one more than the term preceding it. Means 2 is one more than 1, 3 is one more than 2, 4 is one more than 3. Now in the second example, 100, 70, 40, 10 and so on. In this also we can see that each term is 30 less than the term preceding it. Means 70 is 30 less than 100, 40 is 30 less than 70, 10 is 30 less than 40. Now in the third example, 3, 3, 3 and so on. In this example, we can see that each term is obtained by adding or subtracting 0 to the term preceding it. Means 3 plus 0 or 3 minus 0 will give us 3. Now, general form of an AP. This is the general form of an AP. A comma A plus D comma A plus 2D comma A plus 3D and so on. So, first term is denoted as A and the common difference is denoted as small d. Now, A is the first term. Now, the second term will be D more than the first term. So, A plus D. Now, the third term will be A plus 2D means it will be D more than the second term. So, A plus 2D and so on. So, A is denoted as A1, A plus D denoted as A2, A plus 2D can be denoted as A3, A plus 3D can be denoted as A4 and so on. This A1, A2, A3 we can also write as T1, T2, T3, T4 and so on. Now let us clear it with example. If A is given as 5 and D is given as 3, let us find A2. Now we know A2 is A plus D. So A2 is equal to A plus D. But A is given as 5, D is given as 3. So 5 plus 3 is equal to 8. Now let's find A3. A3 is equal to A plus 2D. A3 is equal to A plus 2D. So 5 plus 2 into 3. That is 5 plus 6 is equal to 11. In this way we can find up to A nth term. Now how we can find D? D can be found by A2 minus A1 or A3 minus A2 or A4 minus A3 and so on. So therefore D is found by subtracting any term with its succeeding term. Let us clear it with an example. If AP is given as this, then we have to find the common difference. Now we know how to find common difference, A2 minus A1. So this is A1, A2, A3. So A2 minus A1 is 8 minus 5. So we will do 8 minus 5, that is equal to 3. So therefore common difference of this AP is 3. Now there is a note here. A set of numbers to be an AP, it should have common difference. If the difference is not common, it is not an AP. So there is one formula in this chapter. If it is given that find the nth term, so this is the formula which we will use. An is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. Now what is A here? A is the first term, D is the common difference and N is the number of terms. Now let us clear it with an example. If AP is given as this, we have to find A12. What is A12? Means we have to find the 12th term of this AP. Now what is A here? A is 5. D is equal to A2 minus A1, that is 8 minus 5 is 3. Now what is N given here? That is 12. So we will write the formula. I will put the values in the formula. 5 plus 12 minus 1 into 3. Now 5 plus 12 minus 1 is 11 and 3. Now 5 plus 11 into 3 is 33. Now A12 is 38. The 12th term of this AP is 38 or A12 is 38.
Good morning everyone. My name is K. Roy and today we are going to learn about the probability of cards. Before solving the questions, let us have a brief discussion about the concept of cards. There are total 52 cards in a deck, which is divided into 4 suits, that is, hearts, diamond, club, spade. Each suit contains 13 cards, and ace, number cards from 2 to 10, and face cards, that is, jack, king, and queen. For more understanding, let us solve examples. So, here is our first question. 5 cards, the 10, jack, queen, king and ace of diamonds are well shuffled with their face downwards. One card is then picked up at random. So, we have to find first what is the probability that the card is the queen. Second, if the queen is drawn and put aside, what is the probability that the second card picked up is A, an ace, B, a queen. Okay, we know that total number of cards equal to 5 and number of cards that are queen equals to 1. Therefore, probability of getting a queen equal to 1/5. Second part, here is given that if the queen is drawn and put aside among the 5 cards, then the total number of cards left is equal to 4. Therefore, number of cards that are ace equal to 1. So, probability of getting an ace equal to 1/4. Number of cards that are queen equal to 0. Therefore, probability of getting a queen equal to 0/4. Moving towards the next question. One card is drawn from a pack of 52 cards, each of the 52 cards being equally likely to be drawn. Find the probability that the card drawn is. So, we have to find the probability first, either red or king, second, red and a king, third, a red face card. So, here as we know that there are total 52 cards. Now, according to our question, firstly, we have to find the probability either red or king. So, here we know that there are total 26 cards including king, and we also know that there are total 4 kings. In red card, we have already included 2 kings of hearts and diamond. There are 2 more kings left of black card. So, now total number of favorable cards equals to 26 red card plus 2 black king. Therefore, probability of either red or king equal to 28/52, that is 7/13. Second part of the question is, we have to find the probability of red and a king. Since there are 2 red kings in a pack of 52 playing cards, therefore, favorable number of cards equal to 2. So, probability of red and a king card equal to 2/52, that is 1/26. Third part of the question is to find the probability of a red face card. We know that there are 6 red face cards, 2 jack, 2 king and 2 queen. So, therefore, favorable number of cards equal to 6. Therefore, probability of a red face card equal to 6/52, that is 3/26. Now the next question, from a pack of 52 playing cards, jacks, queen, kings and aces of red color are removed. From the remaining, a card is drawn at random. Find the probability that the card drawn is first a black queen, second a red card. As we know that there are total 52 cards and according to question, 8 cards have been removed. So, therefore remaining number of cards will be 44. So, the first part of the question is to find the probability that the card drawn is a black queen. Since number of black queen is equal to 2, therefore probability of black queen is equal to 2/44, that is 1/22. The second part of the question is to find the probability of a red card. After removing 8 cards from a 26 card, the number of red cards left will be 18. Therefore, the probability of a red card will be 18/44, that is 9/22. This is our next question. One card is drawn from a well-shuffled deck of 52 cards. Find the probability of getting. First, we have to find the probability of a king of red color. Second, a face card. Third, a red face card. Fourth, the jack of hearts. Fifth, a spade. Sixth, the queen of diamonds. Okay. So, here are given that there are total 52 cards. So, first, we have to find the probability of a king of red color. There are total 2 kings in a red color card. That is, from one diamond and second hearts. So, therefore, probability of a king of red color equal to 2/52, that is 1/26. In second part of the question, we have to find the probability of a face card. We know that there are 4 suits. In each suit, there are 3 face cards. So, total number of face cards equal to 12. Therefore, probability of a face card equal to 12/52, that is 3/13. In third part, we have to find the probability of a red face card.
So there are 3 red face card in hertz and 3 red face card in diamond. So total red face cards equal to 6. Therefore, probability of a red face card equal to 6/52, that is 3/26. In fourth part of the question, we have to find the probability of a number of jack of hearts. So we know that there is only one jack of hearts. So therefore, probability of the jack of hearts equal to 1/52. In fifth part, we have to find the probability of a spade. We know that there are only 13 cards in a spade. So therefore, probability of a spade equals to 13/52, that is 1/4. In fifth part, we have to prove that the probability, the queen of diamonds. So we know that number of queen in diamond is equal to 1. Therefore, probability of the queen of diamond equal to 1/52. Moving towards the next question, the king, queen and jack of clubs are removed from a deck of 52 playing cards and the well shuffled. One card is selected from the remaining cards. Find the probability of getting. We have to find the probability of first a heart, second a king, third a club, fourth the 10 of heart. So first we have to find the probability of a heart. After removing 3 cards, that is king, queen and jack of clubs, so total cards are 49. First, total number of hearts of cards equals to 13. Therefore, probability of a heart equals to 13/49. In second, we have to find the probability of a king. After removing king card of club, we are left with 3 king, that is hearts, diamonds and spade. Therefore, number of king equals to 3. So, probability of a king equals to 3/49. In third, we have to find the probability of a club. Since we have removed 3 face card from club, so we are left with 10 cards. Number of cards of club equals to 10. Therefore, probability of a club equals to 10/49. In fourth, we have to find the probability of 10 of hearts. There is only one 10 of hearts. Number of 10 of hearts equals to 1. Therefore, probability of the 10 of hearts equal to 1/49. Moving towards the last question. A card is drawn at random from a well-shuffled deck of playing cards. Find the probability that the card is drawn. So, we have to find the probability. First, a card of spades or an ace. Second, a red king. Third, neither a king nor a queen. Fourth, either a king or a queen. Fifth, a queen or a jack. Sixth, card which is neither a king nor a red card. First part of the question is to find the probability that the card drawn is a card of spades or an ace. We know that total number of cards equals to 52 and number of spade cards equal to 13. And there are total 4 ace cards as one is already included in spades. So number of ace card equal to 3. Now total number of cards will become 13+3 is equals to 16. Therefore, probability of a card of spade or an ace is equal to 16/52, that is 24/13. In second part, we have to find the probability of a red king. Since there are only 2 red kings of hearts and diamond, so number of red king card equals to 2. Therefore, probability of a red king equals to 2/52, that is 1/26. In third part, we have to find the probability of neither a king nor a queen. There are 4 king cards and 4 queen cards, total 8 cards. According to question, probability of neither a king nor a queen. So, total number of cards is equals to 52-8 equals to 44. Therefore, probability of neither a king nor a queen equals to 44/52, that is 11/13. In fourth part, we have to find the probability of either a king or a queen.
So, number of king or a queen card equals to 4 plus 4 equals to 8. Therefore, probability of either a king or a queen equals to 8 by 52, that is 2 by 13. In fifth part, we have to find the probability of a queen or a jack. So, we know that 4 queen cards and 4 jack cards. Therefore, number of queen card or jack cards equal to 4 plus 4 equals to 8. Therefore, probability of a queen or a jack equals to 8 by 52, that is 2 by 13. In sixth part, we have to find the probability of neither red card nor king card. So, total number of red cards including king is equals to 26 and number of king card equals to 2, that is of club and spade. The number of cards which are neither red cards nor kings equals to 52 minus 28, that is 24. Therefore, probability of neither red card nor king is equals to 24 by 52, that is 6 by 13. Let us move on towards the next topic, that is probability of dice. Suppose we throw a single die. Here, we get 6 total number of outcomes, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now, when we throw 2 dice, we get total 36 outcomes. As we can see, numbers on one die pair up with on the other die. We can also calculate number of outcomes by formula 6 to the power n, where n is the number of dice. So, when n equals to 1, we get 6 outcomes, and when n equals to 2, we get 6 to the power 2, that is 36 outcomes. For more understanding, let us solve some examples. So, here is our first example. Suppose we throw a die once. What is the probability of getting? First, we have to find the probability of a number greater than 4. Second, a number less than or equals to 4. Since the number of possible outcomes equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Therefore, total number of outcomes equals to 6. In first part, we have to find the probability of a number greater than 4. So, possible outcomes greater than 4 equals to 5 and 6. Number of greater than 4 equals to 2. Therefore, probability of number greater than 4 equals to 2 by 6, that is 1 by 3. In second part, we have to find the probability of a number less than or equals to 4. So, possible outcomes less than or equals to 4 equals to 1, 2, 3 and 4. Therefore, number less than or equals to 4 equals to 4. So, probability of number less than or equals to 4 equals to 4 by 6, that is 2 by 3. Let us move towards the last question. In a simultaneous throw of a pair of dice, find the probability of getting. So, we have to find the probability of first a doublet, second sum is 8, third sum of a prime number. Since there are 2 dice, therefore total number of outcomes equals to 36. According to these tables, possible outcomes that are doublet equals to 11, 22, 33 till 66. So, number of doublets equals to 6. Therefore, probability of a doublet equals to 6 by 36, that is 1 by 6. In second part, we have to find the probability of sum is 8. So, possible outcomes that sum is 8 equals to 2, 6, 3, 5, 4, 4, 5, 3, 6, 2. Therefore, favorable outcomes equals to 5. So, probability of sum is 8 equals to 5 by 36. In third part, we have to find the probability of sum of a prime number. Since we know that there are 15 outcomes of a prime number. That is 11, 12, 14, 16, etc. Therefore, probability of a prime number equals to 15 by 36, that is 5 by 12.
Good evening, everyone. I am Teva Sheja of class 10J. Ajay, and today I am going to tell you how to solve quadratic equations using quadratic formula. So first of all, the general form of a quadratic equation is ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, where a, b and c are real numbers and a is not equal to 0. Also here, a is the coefficient of x square, b is the coefficient of x and c is the constant term. So first we have to find discriminant, which is d, is equals to b square minus 4ac. So we have rules for d here. Now if d is greater than 0, then there are real and distinct roots. Now if d is equals to 0, then there are real and equal roots. Now if d is less than 0, then no real roots are there. Now so the quadratic formula is x is equal to minus b plus or minus whole root d upon 2a. Now let us understand it better with some examples. Let's take 4x square minus 7x plus 3 is equal to 0. So here a is equal to 4, b is equal to minus 7 and c is equal to 3. Now d is equal to b square minus 4ac. Now here d is minus 7, minus 7 whole square minus 4 into 4 into 3. So 7 square is 49 minus 4 into 4 is 16 and 16 into 3 is 48 is equals to 1, which is greater than 0. Now since d is greater than 0, there are real and distinct roots. So x is equal to minus b plus or minus root d whole by 2a. So minus b, b is minus 7, so minus of minus 7 is plus 7. Plus or minus root d is 1 upon 2 into a is 4. So x is equal to 7 plus or minus root 1 is 1 upon 2 into 4 is 8. So x is equal to 7 plus 1 upon 8 and x equal to 7 minus 1 upon 8. X equal to 7 plus 1 is 8 upon 8, that is x is equal to 1. And here x is equal to 7 minus 1 is 6 upon 8, so x is equal to 3 upon 4. So x is equal to 1 and x is equal to 3 by 4 are the solution of this equation. Now let us take another example. 2x square minus 8x plus 8 is equal to 0. So here again a is equal to 2, b is equal to minus 8 and c is equal to plus 8. Here d is equals to b square minus 4ac. B is minus 8, minus 8 whole square minus 4 into a is 2 and c is 8. So 64 minus 64 is equals to 0. Now since d is equals to 0, then there are real and equal roots. So now x is equal to minus b plus or minus root d whole upon 2a. X equal to minus b, b is minus 6, minus of minus it is plus 8. Plus or minus root 0 whole by 2 into a is 2. So x is equals to 8 plus or minus root of 0 is 0 upon 2 into 2 is 4. X is equal to 8 plus 0 upon 4 and x is equals to 8 minus 0 upon 4. X is equal to 8 plus 0 is 8 upon 4, that is x is equal to 2. Here x is equal to 8 minus 0 is 8 upon 4, so x is equal to 2. So x is equal to 2 is the solution of this equation. Okay, so let's take another equation. 5x square minus 7x plus 3 is equals to 0. Now here we have a is equals to 5, b is equal to minus 7 and c is equals to 3. D is equal to b square minus 4ac. D is equals to b square, that is minus 7 whole square, minus 4 into a is 5, c is 3. So 49 minus 0.5 is 20, 20 into 3 is 60, is equals to minus 11, which is less than 0. Since D is less than 0, there are no real roots for the equation, for the equation. So, to summarize, the usage of quadratic formula is very easy. So, first you just have to find the discriminant to see if the real roots exist or not. And then you have to put it in the quadratic formula, x is equal to minus b plus or minus root d whole by 2a, to find out the roots of the equation. Thank you and have a nice day.